Okay guys, in this video, I'm going to talk to you about modules. So sometimes you're going to have functions that you're going to want to use over and over and over again, maybe not only in the same program, but maybe in different programs. So instead of having to rewrite the function every single time, what you can do is you can throw all the functions that you're going to use over and over again in a separate file, and then just include that file in whatever program you're working on. So not only does it help you from writing a bunch of code, but it also helps organize your program a little bit better. And I'm going to show you guys how to make those right now. So again, like I said, right now we're going to make a module that's just a function included in another file. So we're going to need another file. So right click on your project and write new Python file. So I'll just name this, tuna. So tuna.py. .py is the extension for a Python file, and then hit OK. So now our project has two files in the same directory, this main, which is our main program, the one we've been working on, and this tuna is the one we just made, and we can just delete that. That doesn't really matter. So in this tuna file, I'm just going to make a really simple function right now. So def, and I'll just call it, you can call it anything you want. I'm just name it fish because, I don't know, the module's named tuna, so why the heck not? Alright, so this function is just going to like print something out on the screen. Easy, colons. Alright, I'll just say, I am a tuna fish. There we go. Alright, so say that we wanted to use this function over and over and over again. So we just wrote it once, we threw it in a module, and we're good to go. So now, whenever we actually want to use it, go back to your main program, and what you can do is, in order to use any of the stuff in your module, you first need to say, okay, we want to include another file. So how do we do that? Well, we actually type the word import, and that means go get a file from somewhere else and use it in this program. So then it says, okay, well, what's the name of your file? Well, it's just called tuna. And you don't write py because whenever you import a module, it knows that, of course, it's another Python file. So again, no need to include that py, don't do it, it knows. So right now in this program we're working on, we included basically this. Basically what's going on behind the scenes is it goes to this file, copies it, and pastes it right in here, even though, you know, you don't see it. That's kind of a good example. So if you just run this right now, check it out, nothing happens. Why is that? Well, we included this, but we didn't say to actually use this function right in here. So in order to use functions that are inside modules, we just can't write fish like this. Even though this function is named fish right here, check it out. If we run it, it says, okay, fish is not defined. So why can't we do that? Well, the reason for that is, say we were including a bunch of modules, maybe there's some modules that we wrote, maybe some that our friends wrote, maybe some that some random people on the internet wrote. Well, maybe each of those modules each have a function named fish. So whenever we just call it like this, it's not going to know which function or which function from the module to use. So before we call the function, we need to specify the name of the module that we're using it from. So tuna.fish, what this means is go to tuna, the tuna module, and then from there call the function named fish. So now whenever you run it, check it out, it goes to tuna, finds fish, and calls this or runs it, whatever you want to call it. So that is how we can build our own module and use the crap inside it. But there are also ways to use other people's modules, and I'll show you how to do that right now. So one module that you're going to be using a lot is called random, and this is just a simple one to generate a random number and other random stuff. So if you write import random, actually it just pops up right there, and hit enter, what you did is it basically includes a bunch of functions that they aren't built into the core Python language, but we can just import them really easily. And we can also download other modules from the internet and use those as well, but this is the one, or excuse me, this is one that's included with PyCharm. So whenever we import it, we can use those functions, and I'll show you guys a real simple one real quick. So we'll just make a random number from like 1 to 1,000. Of course, the module's name is random, and a function that is inside it is called randRange. And this just takes a range of numbers like 1, like I said, to 1,000. So now what we did is we generated a random number, 1 to 1,000, stored it in the variable x. And if I just print that out, and hopefully this time it was 236. And who the heck is texting me right now? All right, anyways, I gotta go deal with that. And actually, in the next video, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you guys a real cool way, an easy way, where you can go grab modules from the internet and download them. And the cool thing about it is we don't have to open up our browser or anything. All the tools are built right into PyCharm, so that's what you have to look forward to. I'll see you then.